Dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, the month of October is specially dedicated to the Queen of Rosary, who is the model of integral faith, firm hope, and sincere charity. Let us meditate upon these virtues in detail. Out of God's immense love for all humanity, and for fulfilling His promise of redeeming them from destruction, God took the initiative to bring His redemptive purpose to realization. In order to fulfill the divine plan, God chose a peasant girl from Galilee, daughter of a little known priest and his wife. The angel's address to Mary as full of grace enables us to understand that among all the spiritual blessings in Christ, this is a special blessing because the Father has chosen her as mother of His Son in the Incarnation. At the same time, the fullness of grace indicates all the supernatural benevolence from which Mary benefits by being chosen and destined to be the mother of Christ. Mary, through her faith, accepted the will of God and set apart her life with Jesus for redeeming the fallen humanity. She stands at the point where divine life came into the world and manifested the divine love in order to bring back the souls from the obscurity of ignorance. God's plans for her life are infinitely greater than her own plans. And it is clear from her innocent queries. Mary questions from her point of view, but God points to the greater possibilities at His disposal. But she trusted on the word that with God nothing will be impossible. Trusting in the Almighty, Mary gives her agreement in faith. In the Gospel of Saint Luke, the episode of Annunciation concludes with her readiness, putting herself at the complete disposition of God through her faith. Behold the handmaid of the Lord. Let it be done according to your word. Mary's obedience of faith means to abandon oneself to the truth. In fact, Mary had more faith than all human beings and angels together. She saw her son in the crib at Bethlehem and believed that He is the creator of the world. She saw Him flee from Herod and believed that He is the King of Kings. She saw Him born, yet believed Him to be eternal. She saw Him poor and in need of food and believed that He is the Lord of the universe. She saw Him lying on straw and believed that He is omnipotent. She observed that He did not speak and yet believed that He is filled with infinite wisdom. She heard Him cry and believed that He is the joy of paradise. Finally, she saw Him in death, despised and crucified, and even though faith wavered in others, she remained firm in the conviction that He is God. Hence, Blessed Virgin Mary is our model for ardent faith in God. The Blessed Virgin Mary gave a clear indication of her confidence in God. First of all, when she saw the anxiety of Saint Joseph, unable to understand the mystery of her pregnancy, he thought of leaving her. It then appeared necessary, as we have remarked above, to reveal the secret to him. But Mary could not bring herself to disclose the grace she had received. She thought better to abandon herself to divine providence in the full confidence that God Himself would protect her. Mary showed confidence in God again when she knew that the time for the birth of our Lord was approaching. And when she was driven even from the lodgings of the poor in Bethlehem and obliged to bring forth her child in a stable and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. She did not utter a word of complaint, but abandoned herself totally to God. She also showed her great confidence in divine providence when she learned from Joseph that they had to flee to Egypt. That very night, she was obliged to undertake a long journey to a strange and unknown country without any provisions, without money, and accompanied only by her infant and her poor husband. Mary showed her confidence much more when she asked her son for wine at the marriage feast at Cana. When she said, "They have no wine," Jesus answered her, "What would you have me to do, woman? My hour has not yet come." Even after this answer, which seemed such an obvious rebuff, her confidence prompted her to tell the servants to do whatever her son would tell them to do. She was certain that the favor would be granted. This certainty became evident when Jesus ordered the jars to be filled with water and then changed the water into wine. In the divine providence, Mary was informed that her aunt Elizabeth also is pregnant. So Mary makes her word to Elizabeth in the hope of being able to speak with her and serve her. The meeting of Mary and Elizabeth presents a heartfelt person-to-person dialogue springing from their encounter with God. Each of them senses something of the mystery which the other is bearing within herself. As Mary greets her, Elizabeth too is filled with the Holy Spirit, and she recognizes that Mary is bearing the divine child. Mary receives a profound understanding about the marvelous action of God, which she announces with the canticle Magnificat. It is clear from her words that Mary glorifies and shares God's wonders through the hymn of praise and thanksgiving. Here is a person praying who has experienced the greatness of God. She praises God not only for the great things He has done in her, but for His mercy, which lasts from generation to generation. She praises God that He has chosen the lowly in order to perform great things. Dear friends, let us try to imbibe these virtues in our life and request her constant intercession. Let us pray. O Mother Mary, Mother of all virtues, help us to grow in faith, hope, and charity. Hold our hands to lead a holy life. Amen.